Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand.
In this session, we're going to go over a new feature added to ZoomText and Fusion 2021 in May update of 2021, and that is the Quick Access Bar. Now, the Quick Access Bar is designed primarily for somebody who is looking at the screen, probably using a mouse, and wants to be able to get access to some of the features in ZoomText or Fusion without having to learn a keystroke or having to go all the way back to the UI. You just want to be able to pop up something quickly, make your selection, and then go right back to where you were working. So I've got ZoomText installed on my computer here. And on the UI, we have put an indicator for it. In the top right, next to the microphone, there is now, if you're running ZoomText, a green arrow. If you're running Fusion, it's a red arrow. And that is an indicator to get to the Quick Access Bar. And it shows you here, Quick Access Bar can be brought up at any time using the caps lock key in conjunction with a right mouse click. You can also do this with a keystroke, which is the layered command, caps lock plus space bar, and then the letter Q. Now, if you're running Fusion, it could be insert plus space bar and the letter Q if you're in desktop layout. But I think most users who have a mouse will get used to the caps lock, holding it down and doing a right mouse click to bring it up. You can also just click on this item on the UI window and you will find the feature. So when I bring it up, you notice that, first of all, the main UI of ZoomText went away. So if this one, if this quick access bar is on the screen, the main UI will go away because you probably wouldn't be using both at the same time. Now, let's explore the quick access bar. First of all, I'm going to close it down and I'm going to bring it up using the keystroke, caps lock, and then the mouse click, right mouse click. All right, so you see it popped right up and it popped up at the location of the mouse. If I close it, move the mouse over here and do it over here, it comes up on the left side. So wherever you are focused, so when you have magnification high, it'll come up where you want. Now, the other thing that you might want to be aware of is that there's two views to this. The very narrow view, top to bottom, it's a small window, and it contains basically eight controls. This first one I have is for increasing and decreasing magnification. That's really one control that you have to go into. Then there's one for turning speech on and off, one for speeding it up and slowing it down, a color button, app reader, voice assistant, a microphone. So if you don't want to use the wake up command through speech, and you don't want to use the keystroke to bring it up, you can come to the quick access bar and click that to do a voice command. And then I have 1x toggle. So there's eight items that can go on here. And then there's another item at the bottom for show shortcut name. So that's the thing that opens that window up. Let me bring it back up. Opens that window up for us. And when it's open, you also have something called customize. So we'll come back to this in a minute. First of all, let's just see how it works. So when I click on color, that changes my color settings. It brings the color ones in. I'll turn on speech.
Voice enabled.
And then notice mouse echo has now appeared in my list. So I had mouse echo, but if speech is turned off,
voice disabled,
mouse echo disappears, since you wouldn't be getting mouse echo on and off if your speech is turned off. So I'll turn speech back on.
Voice enabled.
And now if I just click on the desktop, that window goes away and I can go back to doing what I'm working on. If I bring it back up, caps lock, right mouse click, and it's right back where my mouse was, and I can make other adjustments. Okay, so let's look at settings. I'll turn color back
color
off.
Enhancements disabled.
And I'll disable the speech.
Voice disabled.
And I'll go into the settings, the customize. Now, in here, we see we have a menu, a heading at the top here, included shortcuts, 8 of 8. So you have 8 options that you can include, and you can't add any once you've got 8 already in. So if you want to change some of these, you'd want to delete one. You can also choose to move things around in your list if you'd rather position them differently. So toggle zoom and 1x, that's something I use quite a bit. I'm going to right click on that item and I'm going to say move it up. I can right click again, move it up. So I can move that into a different location. And I probably want to bring that right up next to the zoom. So I'm going to go all the way to the top with that one. All right, so now I've got my zoom controls and then the zoom and 1x. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to delete one maybe that I wouldn't be using. So I'm going to delete the mouse echo. You can do it two ways. On the right side, there's an X. You can just click on that, or you can right click and choose delete, and that one goes away. And then I'm going to say OK. So I've saved those settings, and there we are. There's my toggle 1X is right underneath magnification now. I go back down, and I'm going to open settings back up. And we have two things in there, preferences and shortcuts. So I clicked on preferences, and in preferences, automatically hide QA. So this means that if I click away, it goes away. If I uncheck that, it will not hide it. If I click somewhere else, it'll leave it on top. It's not something I want to leave on top. I only bring it up once in a while. So I let it stay on automatically hide. You can also change your colors, and you can change the thickness of the border around the item to make it easier to spot when it pops up. I'll make it a little thicker and I'll say okay. And now the border is a little bit thicker and it's easier to show up. And then if you want to add a shortcut, as long as you have less than 8 in your list, you can come down and click on add shortcuts. And you can pick one to include in there. So maybe focus enhancements is one that I would want to get. And that toggles the focus enhancements on and off. I'm going to say okay. And now it's showing on the bottom of my list. I can move it up if I choose, or I can just say okay, and there it is. So now I've got focus enhancements here. And if I click on that, I'll toggle it on and off as well. So that's a bit about Quick Access Bar. We hope you give this a try, and you may find this a little better than going back to the UI or learning those keystrokes.
Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand. To stay up to date on upcoming webinars and training events, complete the sign-up form at freedomscientific.com/webinars. Thanks again for connecting with us.